According to some estimates, the world's desert can receive more energy from the sun in 6 hours than the entire globe can consume in a year. I'm referring to the breathtaking Sahara Desert. We're all aware that the Sahara is the world's largest desert, but it's also worth noting that it's approximately the same area as China. It stretches across 10 countries and 3 time zones, and it is completely showered by sunlight. On a map that depicts annual sunshine hours around the world, we can see that there are also some prominent hot regions in North America, South America, and Southern Africa, but they're all nothing compared to what the Sahara gets. Why is it so? Well, the Sahara Desert receives a lot of sunlight for 2 main reasons. First, the Sahara Desert sits almost parallel to the Tropic of Cancer, which means that the sun shines straight over it for most of the year. The second reason is that clouds rarely develop or even exist over the whole Sahara Desert, so the sun's rays are not blocked and can freely penetrate the desert. Due to this characteristic of the Sahara, many people believe it is the perfect location on the planet to install solar panels and build solar farms. That got me thinking about what would happen if we filled the entire Sahara Desert with solar panels. I'm interested as to how much electricity we'd be able to generate with those solar panels. What impact would that have on our planet? I did my own study and came up with the following. To start, let's take a look at the Quarzazet Solar Power Station in Morocco, which is currently the world's largest concentrated solar power plant and a marvel of modern engineering. This solar power station was estimated to cover a total area of 25 square kilometers and can produce 582 megawatts of electricity. What's so fascinating about this station is that it can store energy in the form of superheated molten salt, allowing for continued electricity production, even at night. Morocco plans to build 4 more plants like this in the Sahara, since they have already invested more than $9 billion in solar energy. These 4 plants can generate more than 2,000 megawatts of electricity, enough to provide around 38% of Morocco's yearly electricity needs. Because of this investment, and as the only African country with a power line connecting to Europe, Morocco will become the world's leading solar energy country, although much of this energy will be transferred for profit to European Union countries. Take note that this massive amount of energy is generated by only 5 small plants. What happens if we take things a step further? Let's bring in the German energy company Desertec, which is also the investor in the Moroccan solar energy project, and is one of the few companies thinking about Sahara solar energy production in the future. According to their analysis and statistics from the German Aerospace Center, a tiny solar panel array in the Sahara could provide 100% of Germany's total electrical demands. Around 18 trillion watts is what an array of a larger scale can give, which could power the entire European Union, while a much larger array could power the entire world's modern electricity needs. The Desertec project, on the other hand, does not plan to turn the entire Sahara into a solar farm. But the company's vision is still quite grandiose. Their overall plan is to build a chain of enormous solar farms along the Sahara's borders, even further into the Middle East. This series of solar farms is estimated to be able to satisfy the majority of Africa and Middle East's electrical needs, while any excess power will be sent to Europe via cables, which might supply up to 15% of the continent's total electricity needs. Although grandiose, the Desertec company's strategy has been subjected to much research and investment. But aren't you puzzled as to why solar farms will only be built around the Sahara's perimeter? It's mainly because while there are numerous clear advantages to building solar farms in the desert, there are also numerous drawbacks. Well, even if the Sahara is empty and merely no one will be forced to transfer or leave their land, the same emptiness also applies that there is no infrastructure to support the transport of vast amounts of materials into the desert in a cost-effective manner. In fact, there are only around 4 highways that run from north to south throughout the entire Sahara Desert. Some of the areas are more than 600 kilometers from the nearest road, like the one in Chad, This essentially means that transporting billions of solar panels in the Sahara will require numerous new roads or railroads to be constructed, and that would be very expensive all on its own. DesertTech does not intend to go that far, and its plans solely include the construction of plants within the perimeters of the Sahara. How much would the entire project cost if we would continue to cover the Sahara with solar panels? A single solar panel that can generate an average of 350 watts per hour already costs between $200 and $450. This means the cost of the whole project would be even higher, since moving and installing these solar panels in the Sahara would be very expensive alone. That being said, there might be an extra $300 in infrastructure costs and $250 in installation fees. With this calculation, the previously mentioned $200 to $450 for a 350 watt solar panel will now cost $1,000. That also means that the 51.4 billion solar panels that are needed to fully cover the Sahara to power the entire planet will cost 51.4 trillion US dollars. That's equal to 60% of global GDP. This would also allow us to switch all of our electricity to renewable solar power. Let's say we accept the challenge and invest the necessary funds to totally cover the Sahara Desert in solar panels. So what's going to happen now? Assuming that the solar panels are 100% efficient, the Sahara Desert could generate roughly 1.3 million terawatt hours of electricity per year. Consider this. In 2019, the entire human population spent around 173,000 terawatt hours of energy, and that number already includes all kinds of energy humans consumed for that year, not just electricity. Taking that into account, it's evident that solar panels covering the Sahara Desert would create more than 7 times the amount of electricity consumed by the entire planet's population right now. Obviously, this would mean revolutionary advances in humanity's capabilities, not just a step closer to a Type 1 Kardashev civilization. However, even if there are benefits, there are also drawbacks if we cover the Sahara with solar panels. The solar panels covering the Sahara, for example, will absorb the majority of the sunlight that falls on it. However, only a small portion of that heat will be transformed into electricity, and the remaining will be sent back to the environment as heat. As a result of this heat, a feedback loop will occur. So, what is this feedback loop? The heat that is sent to the environment by the solar panels would cause a large temperature difference in the surrounding lands and oceans of the Sahara. As a result, the surface air pressure would drop, allowing moist air to rise and condense into clouds and rain across the desert. This means that if we cover the entire Sahara Desert in solar panels, we are also transforming the desert into a green Sahara. In some instances, this will be beneficial, because it will free up a vast land that can be used for colonization, human habitation, and most importantly, for North Africa's enormous economic development for their country and their people. This, on the other hand, would be disastrous. Dust carried over the Atlantic from the Sahara feeds and fertilizes the Amazon rainforest in South America. While the Atlantic ecosystems likewise benefit from this nutritious diet, if the Sahara becomes a green Sahara, eliminating all of the desert sands might trigger a chain of unanticipated events that could destroy the entire ecosystem in the Atlantic, the Amazon, and even in other places. A climate catastrophe that we had never experienced before could be the result of all of this. In conclusion, while covering the entire Sahara with solar panels would be amazing, it is also impractical. It would be dangerous for other desert-dependent ecosystems on the planet, and it isn't even necessary. Yes, solar panels are required to supply the modern electrical needs of all 8 billion inhabitants, but they do not need to be located in the same place. They may be scattered across the world's deserts or anywhere that is sunny enough. And hopefully, sometime in the future, we should have made a significant development toward a more environmentally friendly power source. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Please click the bell icon so you'll be notified when new videos are posted. And as always, thanks for watching Ponder This.